Hello, it's Mick here, and today we'll look at the decomposition rate of your soil. Decomposition rate is important for nutrient cycling and carbon storage, among many other soil functions. This method is inspired in the global tea composition initiative, in which tea bags are used to look at the decomposition rate across time and different sites. By the way, for this method, we should bury tea bags in May or June in the Northern Hemisphere, or around November-December in the Southern Hemisphere. To follow the decomposition methodology, you will need for each of the areas you want to study 8 marking sticks, 16 green tea bags, 16 red bush tea bags, a waterproof pen to label the tea bags, some Ziploc bags or other waterproof recipients with lid, a precise scale, a little spade, tape measure, and some tape if you wish to secure the labels to the tea bags. In each zone, we select 2 representative sampling areas of at least a square meter with gentle slope. Physically mark these areas with sticks or colored stones and record the altitude and GPS coordinates. If possible, record as well the soil type. Label the tea bags with a unique code that represents the number of the tea bags, the type of tea, and the zones you are studying and the sampling area you are studying. This is 1 or 2. For example, you could name it 2GRCOM1. To make sure the labels of the tea bags would not disappear, we decided to use tape and noted the codes of each tea bag on top of the tape. Weigh the tea bags before burial and record the weight. Place tea bags in Ziploc bag or box until burial. Then note the starting date of incubation. Using string and nails, mark 4 lines of 1 meter in each sampling area, with at least 10 centimeters between the line. Then note the starting date of incubation or tea burial. Gently dig 4 slots of approximately 5 centimeters, separated by 30 centimeters along each line, creating a pocket for the tea bags. Along each line, bury 2 green tea and 2 rooibos tea bags, roughly 5 centimeters deep. Make sure the identifier codes on the tags are visible on the surface. Then plan the retrieval dates or sampling points in your calendar. This could be 3, 12, 24 and 36 months after burial. This for the other sampling area to get 4 bags of green and 4 bags of rooibos tea per zone. Gently clean tea bags from roots, soil and so forth, and note if bag was damaged or found at the surface. Place every tea bag in a Ziploc bag or in a box. Then dry the tea bags at 70 degrees for 48 hours. Determine the weight of an empty tea bag and note this weight. Then measure the weight of each tea bag. Record the results in the data sheet. Repeat this procedure after 12, 24 and 36 months. Using this method, we are able to calculate the average percentage of decomposed tea in our different zones of our camp. However, the small size of the holes in the mesh of tea bags means that this rate is a good proxy for microfauna activity and less appropriate for meso and macrofauna. If you are interested in the latter, we recommend creating native litter bags using local litter and a larger mesh. If done following the decomposition protocol carefully, this data could be included in a database of global research on soil decomposition.